The number of people unemployed across the nation is at its highest in over a decade, with almost 2 million out of work. And Greater Manchester hasn't escaped the effects of the economic downturn. Here, the number of jobless stands at just over 64,000, a rise of 10% on the previous month.
I think the effect is pretty much across the board, and it's difficult to separate out particular districts. Obviously, we've had news on particular firms, but that doesn't always correlate with where people live. What we would point out, though, is that some of the most deprived neighbourhoods in Manchester, where worklessness has been a problem even during the better economic times that we've had, are going to be important for us to continue a focus on, because it's important that we don't forget those people who we've been trying over the last few years to get back into work because of the focus at the moment on redundancies. January is always traditionally a tough month, particularly for retail and the service sector, when people are traditionally laid off after the Christmas period.
The figure for people claiming Job Seekers Allowance in Greater Manchester has doubled in the last 12 months. The eighth month in a row, the number of claimants has gone up. And getting back into work is also proving difficult. Job vacancies in Greater Manchester now stand at just over 6,000.
I think it's important to try and keep this in context. Although the situation is clearly a worrying one, the data that we're looking at certainly doesn't place us anywhere near the recession of the early 90s, let alone the early 80s at this point. And there are some clearly underlying strengths within the Manchester economy, which may still stand us in good stead. Certainly on last month's data, there were a significant number of new companies starts, and there are clearly continuing vacancies in particular sectors.
And if you think things are bad now, chances are they're going to get even worse. That's according to the Governor of the Bank of England, Mervyn King, who's today admitted that there is a significant risk that the recession could be longer and deeper than previously expected. In the latest forecast, the bank says the UK economy will decline sharply in the first half of this year. Any recovery depends on the world economy and the ability to improve the availability of credit and restore business and consumer confidence. Mervyn King says a severe economic downturn has now taken hold around the world. Inflation is expected to remain below its 2% target, and interest rates have already been cut from 5% to 1% in the last 5 months.